Hello friends, welcome to this series of video lectures on pointers in C programming language by Gate Gyan. Pointers are somewhat difficult to understand topic, but in this series of lectures I will make it very easy for you to understand pointers. So let's just start. In this lecture we will have an introduction to pointers. Okay, so first let's see what is a pointer. A pointer is a variable which contains the address of another variable. What it means is that pointer is also a kind of variable which contains the address of another variable. The another variable can be an integer variable, can be a boolean variable, can be a double variable, can be a float variable, or any type of variable. Only job of pointer is to contain the address of a variable. Okay, so you must be thinking, what do you mean by the address of a variable? Okay, by address of a variable we mean that whenever we declare a variable, that variable is assigned a specific location in memory. The starting address of that location is the address of the variable. Let's just understand what it means. So whenever you declare a variable, let's say we declare a variable var which is of type int. So whenever you declare this variable, it must be assigned a memory location in the memory, because it is stored in the memory of the system. Let's say the variable where is stored in this memory location, this block. Okay, this block of the memory. Okay, so this block must have an address, because system must know where this variable is located, so that it can fetch it later using this using its location. In the same way, you have an address, you give your address to someone, and using that address the other guy searches you and finds you. In the same way, the machine has a address associated with each memory location. So starting address of this memory location is known as the address of that variable. It's clear? Now next, we know that we can already access a variable using its name. If we have a variable and we have a name for it, like for example int var, we can access this variable using its name. Int var, we can access this variable using its name. Okay, so why we need pointers in the first place? So we need pointers because when we access an element using its name, ultimately it has to be converted into logical address, and then logical address has to be converted to physical address. Okay, so ultimately you have to obtain the physical address, then you can access the variable. But if you have a pointer that is containing the address of that variable, you have the address directly and you can access the variable directly without these conversions. So it is faster. Okay, and one thing to important note here is that the size of a pointer is always same and fixed in a system. Why? Size of a pointer is fixed. Any system uses a specific number of bits to address a memory location. So our pointer should be able to contain only those number of bits. It means that any system or any platform has a fixed number of bits which it uses to address any memory location within the system memory. Okay, so and what our pointer is containing? The address of the memory location. So it should be able to contain only those number of bits which is required by the system to address the memory location. So hence, it doesn't matter if you start storing the address of an integer or a boolean or a double or any kind of variable in the pointer, size of the pointer will always be equal to the number of bits system uses to address the memory. So for a given system, the size of a pointer will always remain same. So you must be thinking how I can declare a pointer variable. You can declare a pointer variable in the following way. First, you have to specify the data type of the pointer variable, and then the name of the pointer variable, and then in front of the name you have to put a star symbol. For example, you write int star ptr. What it means that ptr is a pointer to a variable of type integer. Okay, that means that ptr can store the address to a variable of type integer. Okay, now you must be having a question, is that if all the pointer variables have the same size within the system, why we need to specify the data type of the pointer? This is because when doing pointer arithmetic, which we will discuss in the next upcoming lectures, data type of a pointer is required. Otherwise, we can't do pointer arithmetic using that pointer variable. Now, I already said you that we can store the address of a variable inside a pointer variable. So how we can assign the address of a variable into a pointer variable? We can assign the address of a variable to a pointer using ampersand operator. Okay, for example, if we have a variable a of type integer, and we have a declare a variable p of a variable p which can point to a variable of type integer. That is, p is a pointer which can contain the address of an integer variable. Then we can assign the address of a using ampersand operator in this way. What does it mean? That whenever you declare a, there is a fixed memory location for a, and it has a specific address. Let's assume in this case it is 4000. Then, and when you declare p, since p is also a variable, it is declared, it is stored in a memory location and has its own block and address. So what happens is that the value of p becomes equal to the address of the variable a, that is 4000 is stored here. So when you write p, it is as good as standing outside the block, this block, that is the block of the variable. Okay, now we know how we can store the address of a variable in a pointer. Now what's the use of storing? We can dereference a variable. We can dereference a variable using a pointer. How we can do it? When I already told you that whenever you have a pointer variable which stores the value of the address of a variable, what happens is that whenever you write this variable, you are standing here, and there is a dereference operator. There is a dereference operator that is a star. If you write star in front of a pointer variable, you are inside this block. So you can access the value of a variable for which pointer stores the address by using dereference operator star p. So writing star p is same as writing a, because when you write a, you are inside this block, and when you write p, inside you are inside this block. Okay, so a is equivalent to star p, and where a is a variable and p is a pointer variable which stores the address of a. Okay, now just look at an example to understand the things better. I have a snippet of code here. Here we are declaring a variable of type integer. Okay, so let's say this variable is stored in a memory location whose address is 100, and since we are storing 9, so 9 is inside this box. Okay, now we are declaring a pointer variable, okay, which can point to an integer, and we are assigning to it the address of the variable var. Okay, so what happens is that pointer variable ptr is located a memory location in the memory, and it is assigned an address. Let's say its address is 400, and what is stored is the address of the variable var, that is 100. So ptr is pointing to this variable. Okay, so now just look at this question. print f percentage d var. So what's the value of this var? What's the value? Writing var means inside this block. So what's the inside this block? 9. So 9. Okay. Ampersand var. Ampersand var means address of var. What is the address of var? 100. 100. PTR. What's the PTR? PTR is same as standing inside this box. What is the value inside this box? 100. 100. Okay. Star PTR. Writing PTR is same as standing outside this box, and writing star in front of PTR is same as standing inside this box. So what's the value inside this box? 9. So here is the value 9. And ampersand PTR. What is the address of the PTR variable? 400. So 400. So here is the little introduction of pointer. In the next lecture, we'll study in more depth about pointers. So if you want to download these notes, these notes are available in my blog. I've included the link to my blog in the description section. You can go there and download the notes in the PDF format. And don't forget to leave your feedback in the comment section. And please feel free to ask any doubt you have in the comment section. I would love to answer them. And please, please like and share this video with your friends. And please subscribe to my channel if you want more such videos, because I will be uploading such videos daily.